here are the three biggest SMA opportunities in 2020. So if you're new to this channel, my name is Jaime and I help other agency and SMA owners master sales and outreach, landing more meetings, signing more clients and scaling their agency. What I want to do in this video is give you some of my opinion on the new trends that we're going to be seeing in 2020 and the biggest opportunities when it comes to services and niches in 2020. If you're trying to build out your agency, if you're just starting out, or you're looking to pivot and really take things to the next level in 2020 with your agency, you know, really scale maybe to six figures, scale it even to seven figures, this video is going to be of huge value to you, because not only am I going to be giving you the real tangible opportunities that I see and that I've seen really develop as amazing trends and really as huge opportunities, but also kind of the mindset behind these opportunities and really my opinion on why it is so important to really go deep and really go narrow when it comes to your service delivery and when it comes to really appealing to a very narrow and niche audience. So without further ado, let's hop on my computer. I prepared a slideshow for you guys. It's gonna be real juicy, so let's get right into it. The three biggest SMA opportunities in 2020. No fads, just two services and one niche idea. Really just no fads, okay? I'm not gonna be talking about fads that are gonna be here today and gone tomorrow, that's really one of the things that I'm really, really big on. I don't like to build a business on a fad. I don't like to build a business on something that is not necessarily going to be here in, you know, 5 years from now. It's not going to be here in 10 years from now. Yes, I'm a true believer in you know, catching trends and really, you know, riding as certain waves. But I only do it if the core principles that I'm gonna learn from riding that specific wave can be applicable and transferable to other financial vehicles or other niches or other, you know, services. Whether, you know, if I'm actually gonna acquire tangible skills that I'm gonna be able to apply later on in my business, you know, in my career, in my business life, and that are gonna actually enhance me as a person. So a long-winded way of saying that it's not gonna be fads. What I am talking about here is genuine and real opportunities to position your SMA in a way that will give you a competitive advantage. And that's really one of the themes that I want this video to take, is, you know, the fact that we have to realize that every single year, the digital marketing sphere is more and more saturated. There's a lower barrier to entry because, you know, softwares like ClickFunnels or, you know, there's just tons of softwares that have made it just so effortless for someone to, you know, get up and running and really learn this whole ecosystem. And so the barrier to entry is much lower now, which means a lot of people are flocking to it. And so if you really want to have true success with it, you have to find a way to differentiate yourself and really get, you know, approach it in a complete different angle that, you know, maybe people haven't thought of, or that maybe you know, people just are too lazy to do, right? So we have to realize that most people are going to be taking the conventional route at what most people are doing. People, you know, most people are just followers and most people just follow the crowd. And so if you can position yourself in a way that not many people are doing, and also just be better, then you're really gonna see massive results. And so yeah, that is one of the things that I want you guys to consider. But why is positioning so important? I just talked about that. Really, SMA in 2020 is all about positioning, approaching SMA in a complete different angle that a lot of people haven't thought of before, and really standing, you know, and really just being the almost the market leader. Because what you have to realize is, you know, and I talked about this in one of my previous videos. You know, you can check it out here. But really, you have to realize that, especially if you're going for the big clients are going to go with number one or number two agencies. Okay, they're not going to go for, you know, they're not going to go for number 15 in the list. They're going to go for the top ones. And so if I'm talking here, you know, about the people that really want to build a really successful agency, if you really want to have incredible success, you have to be top, you know, number one, number two in a specific niche. You might think that's crazy, that's impossible. But the way you can do that is by going either very niche or tapping into a mainstream niche that a lot of people haven't, you know, thought of, or having that first mover advantage. So I'll be talking about that in just a second. But yeah, SMA in 2020, things to keep in mind again: more stream, barrier to entry is lower and more people are flocking to the exact same thing. Need to stand out. Two ways you can do this: you can, yeah, as I said, you can go very niche with a saturated industry, for example. You can go You can, you know, take Facebook ads. So you do Facebook advertising, which is, you know, that specific service is a bit saturated. Or a lot of people are offering it, so there's a lot of offer. But for example, you can pick Invisalign, which is, you know, a type of dentist work, like braces, for example. You can pick dentists that only focus on Invisalign, and you can be the top agency for that. So really, really going very, very niche in a saturated industry, or you can, and higher price points. So people are, you know, and offer just a solution that's very valuable to those people, because it's very, very niche. It's a solution that works just for them, but it solves a massive problem for them. Or you can go, as I said, go more into a massive untapped niche. And I'll be talking, you know, those are, you know, some of the opportunities that I'm going to be talking about today go into that specific category, which is a massive untapped niche that a lot of people haven't yet flocked to. And you can really have that first mover advantage if you do things right and you stand as an authority, as a trusted person in that space. And so the first one, you guys might have heard of this platform. I'm a big, big fan of TikTok. In fact, I put out a lot of content on TikTok. TikTok, the way I see it, and obviously backed by a lot of data, It honestly has huge potential. It's got more active users than Instagram, and it's still very, very early. Maybe a bit too early, and I'll be talking about this in just a second. And there's also a myriad of different services you can offer. You can offer paid ads. A lot of big companies have already jumped on that, and they're really, you know, the way I see them, especially when they pop up when I'm, you know, checking out on the app and creating content. When it pops up, it's really native. They're native ads. And so the way that most brands are doing TikTok ads is so native. They're doing it so well. The content that they put out is so tailored to TikTok that you almost don't realize it's an ad. It's very natively, you know, it's amazingly well done. It's very native. And so it's got a huge potential. I can only imagine that they're getting incredible returns, and the CPMs are probably, you know, are probably quite low in comparison to other more saturated online advertising platforms, which have more competitors in them. And so that's paid ads. You can also do account management. You can do content creation, which is a bit harder to coordinate, but you can even do content creation. You know, they can send out, maybe a company can send out products for you. You can put out some videos. You can put together some videos for them. You can also do hashtag research. You can do music creation. So if you guys don't know, with TikTok, you can create a soundbite, and you can make it kind of go viral. If you say the right growth hacking strategies, you can get, you know, a challenge going. People doing a little dance for that specific music bite. And so there's so many different services that you can offer around TikTok. And if you can, you know, if you can be seen as an authority, for example, one of the ways that you can do it, you can start putting out content about TikTok on LinkedIn and be seen as this, you know, huge authority. You stand a good chance of being, you know, a recognized agency, a recognized TikTok agency in the space. And so when people think about doing TikTok advertising, or when people you know, consider it, they're gonna go to you instead of going to an agency that does a killer job at Facebook advertising, but it's just as in the waters with TikTok, right? Because again, people want to, you know, people care about results. Okay, if you live, breathe, and sleep at TikTok, then more likely than not, you can get them better results. And so, yeah, that's the first thing. The second thing that I want to mention on TikTok is that many haven't jumped the first hurdle. So let me explain what this means. There's basically, in a sales process, there's, you know, this one way to think about sales, but in a sales process, there's basically two hurdles. Number one, do they believe in the service that you're pitching? Second hurdle is, do they believe that you're the right person to offer that service to them? So ideally, what you always want to do is you want to avoid getting people to jump over the first hurdle. Ideally, the ideal prospects that you want to reach out to are prospects that are already over the first hurdle, because otherwise it's really, you know, you're going to be in a very weak position where you're trying to convince them of the service, and you're trying to qualify your service, and you're just going to waste a lot of time. Whereas if they already see the value, then it's just a matter of you conveying enough value to them, and, you know, allowing them to see that you're the right person to go with when it comes to that specific service. The thing I see, though, is that since TikTok is very early in the journey, a lot of businesses haven't caught up. I mean, you know, heck, a lot of people haven't even caught up to TikTok. It's mostly a very young audience, as you guys probably know, although it's maturing by the day, but it still hasn't reached that that point of maturity where businesses are going to be, you know, really seeing the incredible value. Second thing is SMS marketing. Really has huge potential. You know, some of the stats that I want to run past you are open rates at 98%, time to reach at 30 seconds to 2 minutes, and click-through rate at 8.6 to 13.3%. Those are some very, very crazy stats. It's a very, very high revenue generating activity. And if you, you know, if you can present those stats to a company, they're much, much, it'll be much easier to get them to jump through that first hurdle that, I talked to you about. There's many ways that you can do this. You know, one of them is, you know, taking Facebook Messenger, so ads and bots. I know for a fact that there's a bunch of agencies already doing purely Facebook Messenger ads, and so they just focus on that on the Messenger vertical. They'll do ads, they'll do bots, and they'll, you know, kind of automize that whole system. You can do WhatsApp, and you can do and you can just do regular SMS services. Fairly untapped, very few businesses are doing it, and the reason why it's got huge potential is because an SMS right now goes unimpeded through the huge walls that most people have built up around online advertising. The reason why this is because SMS is a much more personal and intimate environment. Also, even if they don't open it, the way most mobile devices work is it will still give them a snippet of the message, and so it really has almost a guaranteed read rate, which is pretty crazy. But yeah, that is another angle that you can take your agency, really position yourself as the SMS marketing agency. You know, you only focus on SMS, and you absolutely do a killer job at it. You put content around, you put out content around SMS, and you build out this authority around SMS. You know, everything that goes on about SMS, and you really have an incredible chance to become, one of the most well-known SMS marketing agencies out there in 2020. So that's the second thing. And lastly, CBD. So instead of a service, there's a niche. Huge potential. Facebook still has very, very strict restrictions on CBD companies. But in the past few months, they've actually been more laid back. They've introduced, for example, now you can advertise, I won't get into too much detail, but now you can advertise products that you don't actually ingest. So maybe that you actually put on your skin, CBD that you eat, ingestible CBD is not allowed to run ads at all. But you know, CBD that you actually apply on serum, for example, actually can be allowed to run ads if you don't include CBD on the pictures, etc. I won't get into too much detail, but it's not an immediate opportunity, but it is a massive growing industry, and positioning yourself as the go-to agency in the space will be very, very lucrative. The reason why it's not an immediate opportunity is because Facebook is still very strict, but I truly believe that in 2020, we're gonna be seeing, and this is just my prediction, but we're gonna be seeing Facebook introduce, kind of step back a bit and allow CBD companies to actually advertise on Facebook. Obviously, I truly believe there's still gonna be restrictions and the way they advertise, but you know that it's still marketing for CBD companies. It doesn't even have to be Facebook ads. There's tons of ways you can do it, but positioning yourself as the, you know, as a CBD, you know, go-to agency is very, very lucrative, and that's what I wanted to get across. Before I actually finish the presentation, what I want you guys to take away from this, you know, little slideshow and this three opportunities is not so much the opportunities. You know, I'd be so happy if you guys take, you know, some of these opportunities and decide to tackle them and become the go-to agency for these opportunities. But the main takeaway from this video is that you really, you know, in 2020, especially if you're just starting out, especially, and even if you're starting to scale, the more niche that you go, the better. Because for example, if you're doing e-commerce, right, which I see this one problem that I see a lot of people have, if you're doing e-commerce and you're reaching out to, you know, 1 week you're reaching out to watch companies, and then the next week you're reaching out to cosmetic companies, the thing is, there'll be cosmetic based agencies that only just focus on cosmetic companies and beauty clients that are gonna go to the prospects that you're reaching out to. And guess who's gonna get that contract, or just maybe that call or that opportunity to talk to them? It's gonna be the people that actually specialize, because first of all, they're gonna have a clientele full of beauty clients, which gives them massive social proof, because they've actually been through the tensions. They know what works in that industry, and people just trust people that actually know about their industry. They're just in a much more expert position, and they're more likely to go with that. agency than your agency, even though you may have very good clients, but maybe you have this massive, you know, massive watch company that you signed 2 weeks ago, but it's not a cosmetic company. And so, you know, a lot of people have this misconception that if they narrow down or they go very niche, then they want, you know, they're cutting themselves short. But it's actually completely different. It's actually the opposite. The more narrow you go, the more people that are going to be seeing you as the authority, more people that are going to go to you, and the more lucrative and profitable it's going to be for you. And the easier it's going to be to sign the clients that actually work for you. That's one thing. And the second thing is that the service delivery is going to get so much easier because, look, you're going to know what works, what doesn't, what kind of ad copy works, what kind of creatives work for your specific niche, what kind of, you know, front end offers work, what kind of funnels work. And so everything is just going to get exponentially better. Not only that, but also signing clients is going to get much easier because you're going to be able to speak from, you know, speak their language, understand where they're coming from, speak, you know, kind of speak to their competitors, what their competitors are doing, speak to that. And what I can tell you from experience, what I can tell you is that really impresses them because you almost like them. You're on a level playing field. You almost know either as much or a little bit more than them about their industry. And that really, really excites them because, you know, you're coming in as an expert of that niche, not only as an expert of that service, but as an expert of their niche. And they love that. And so that's really the thing that I want you guys to take away from this video is really position yourself, give your agency a complete different angle that a lot of people are not thinking about, that a lot of people are not tapping into, and you reap massive, massive, massive success. Not only with your sales, not only with your service delivery, but also standing out from the noise of the digital marketing sphere and asserting your place as an authority in your niche. And so, yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and drop a like in this video. It really helps out a ton with the algorithm, helps out get my channel and my videos to a lot more people and help a lot more people with sales and outreach. Leave in the comments any topics that you'd like me to cover next. I'll definitely be checking those. And lastly, guys, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, go ahead and do that right now. I'm going to be putting out so many videos, so much content around SMA, not only sales and outreach, which I'm extremely passionate about and I love talking about because I truly, truly believe that's going to be that's really going to have the biggest impact on the growth of your SMA and the success of your SMA, but also anything related to SMA. That's, you know, service delivery, building a team, building incredible systems and processes, really just this 360 approach to SMA. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel and you want to check those videos out, go ahead and do that right now. Hope everything's going well with your agency journey. Until next time, keep killing it and peace.